The Titanic, this beautiful ship, has been the discussion of many documentaries, films and books around the world. Truly a magnificent ship for its time. This ship went down on its maiden voyage from England to New York in 1912. Sculpture Studios has been contacted by another sculptor named Tony Stallard to create this Titanic ship in third scale to look like an Airfix kit in giant form. Although at first sight it seemed like a really wonderful project to take on, it did prove very, very difficult in terms of its challenges and measurements, really. Now, to actually get started, we actually scoured the internet and found all the blueprints and drawings and all the kind of schematics that we could find to actually make sure that we got the project right from the start. The sculptor actually gave us this small scale model to look at, and so it gave us a vision of what he wanted his sculpture to look like in the end. We actually decided to work from one particular drawing, and then we gridded it up, and then we got a plastic model so we could actually see it in 3D as well. Now, where to start is always the most difficult part of a project. So we actually gridded it up and made it in polystyrene big blocks, and then we started to sculpt it with wire brushes and hot wires. I've never actually done something quite like this before in my life, where I've taken so many measurements and measurements, reference points, stuck drawings and pins all over it and checked it again and again. It has been a real learning curve, and you know, it's been interesting. The funny thing is, once we actually completed one side, we knew then again we had to then duplicate it exactly the same on the other side. So what we actually did was took tracings and drawings, and then we just flipped it over and we created a mirror image to make the other side, which saves us a lot of time. When you work on projects such as this, you almost become an anorak on these things. We knew every little porthole and every plate and every rivet that was on the ship after this. We also made a preliminary test part for them to send away to the foundry and to take their castings from. Once this came back and it was all okayed, we carried on with the whole process. We finished the pieces and we sanded them and painted them. When we completed each individual piece, we sent them down to Braintree to the bronze foundry, where they took the grog cast and then started their bronze casting process. With all the work being done and actually being put on its kind of web frame, here it is being loaded onto the lorry and being brought to Belfast site. The entire ship is bronze with the mild steel frame exterior. As you can see here, just some parts of it is painted up and some parts have polished in bronze. And here it is, actually on site in Belfast, in its full glory, standing upright. I always think seeing a project from start to completion is always a fantastic thing to do. You know, actually seeing it from concept, from drawings to pattern making, polystyrene carving, you know, sending it to the bronze foundry, seeing it put on its metalwork and brought to site and erected is always really, really rewarding. It's like a nice story coming together. With a very successful ending. So, yeah, really enjoyed this project. Thank you very much indeed, Tony Stallard.